Hey, how's it going? This is yours truly, Freddie Banks. Welcome back to my channel. Be sure to hit that like and subscribe and help me get that algorithm up for this channel. Today's video is going to be cool. I'm going to give you a run through of my home setup for recording, practicing, tracking, and my little keyboard kingdom, as I can just call it right now. But yeah, just giving you some insight as to what I use, the equipment that I use on a regular, my favorite gear. I'm not sponsored by any of these brands. None of them are paying me to speak about their gear. This is all just things that I've acquired over the years and things that I've grown to love and appreciate. And I just want to share that with you all. So yeah, be sure to like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and just jump right into it. Let's go. Okay, so here we are at the main centerpiece of my home setup, which is the, I'll start with the controller and I'll work my way around to the computer. But this controller is a Studio Logic SL88 Studio controller. It's around in the $500 range, 500, 600 maybe so. But either way, it's a very affordable option, but also quality wise, I love it for playing and controlling maybe like a VST or even a MIDI to another keyboard if I'm playing some piano and doing some work with that. It's sporting three different MIDI outputs on the back of it. No, you probably can't see it, but it has USB MIDI out, which is already going to the computer. And then you have the option of having two additional MIDI outs, and I'm using one of them to go over to my other station to the side. So overall, I think that this is a great option if you're looking for a MIDI controller to use. It has great feel. It's not like the wooden keys. If you want wooden keys, you can get the SL88 grand version, which is almost around $1,000, and that has wooden keys with that action, and I've heard good things about that. But I'll put a link to this this product in my description if you want to check that out. But as I said, it has MIDI out going over here to this guy, the infamous Nord Stage. I have the Nord Stage 3 compact 73 semi-weighted action. There are some people that are, you know, more particular about having the weighted option or the hammer portable option, but for me, the semi-weighted is cool for playing synthesizer action, organ action. I love the organ on the Nord, of course. It sounds great, especially if I'm doing like some jazz or gospel tracking. I love the organ for that. You know, gospel, you know, you gotta have some good organ. But I love it for that. I love the pianos in here. My favorite is the white grand that I already have set up. White grand, sometimes I'll use grand imperial or the uprights, like the pearl upright, the amber upright. Those are my favorites. And then if I'm doing like some lo-fi R&B or whatever, like the mellow upright works well for that. But that's another video for another time. But all in all, I love the Nord. Interesting fact, if you do some research about how you set up the SL88 with the Nord and have it in the dual keyboard mode right here, what would happen is that the panel B piano, which is by default, it goes to Royal 3D, but if I put it to White Grand, the SL88 will solely control the White Grand alone in panel B. And then your synth and your organ will only be triggered if you play the Nord, which is something that I've learned and discovered and found out how to use. And I thought that was amazing. And I've saw even in like a Nord user group on Facebook that a lot of people do that, even specifically with the SL88. But yeah, the Nord has a lot of options for that. So MIDI in from the SL88 to the Nord. I also have MIDI out of the Nord going to the Gaia, which is a fun synthesizer to play. Even if you're new to synthesizers and you don't want to spend a whole lot on like a Profit Rev 2 or an Oberheim or, you know, any of those like high-end legendary synthesizers, the Gaia is a good option, is a good place of entry for you for that. What's cool about the Nord and any external instrument is that you have an external dedicated setting right here. This little strip is dedicated for using external instruments. You can turn it on, of course, and you can control the key zone of how many octaves you want to have it play. You can select octave up and octave down. And this knob right here is interchangeable in controlling the volume, the program, MIDI CC, sustain pedal with this button and a pitch stick. So all of that stuff, the sustain pedal from the Nord, the pitch stick of the Nord can control that of the, it can have that same control over the Gaia. So you don't even have to touch the Gaia per se while you're playing. Everything can be done from the Nord and you have full control over that. So that's another cool feat about the Nord. And yeah, I think that's great. I love having it connected to the SL8018 Nord just to have the flexibility and option of tracking however I need. So it just matters. It just depends on the day and the mood. If I want to play piano from the SL88 or from the Nord, or if I just want to play Rhodes or organ and or any of that type of thing. But even down here, you got some pedals, pretty typical pedals. I know some real serious keyboard players prefer the FC7 pedal or the F7 pedal, or whatever it's called, made by Yamaha. I may check that out in the future, but these pedals work fine for now. I have a Proline expression pedal that I use for my control pedal that I may assign for other effects on the Nord for the synthesizer. My Roland EV5 expression pedal is for the organ swell, so that you can have those swelling effect and you can automate and express like the true swelling effect of playing like a Hammond organ. And I have a Roland DP sustain pedal, the one that's famous for having the little non-slip tongue underneath it, so you can just anchor your ankle underneath it so that you don't have to spend time chasing sustain pedals while you're playing. Keyboard players already know how much of a struggle that is, but that's the solution that I have for that. So that's that section. And over here, the audio from both of these boards are migrating over here to the Radial Key Largo. The Key Largo is made by Radial, of course. I just said that, duh. But it works as a keyboard submixer, as I'm using it for, but also you can use it as a direct box and also as an USB MIDI interface to record with. But for me, I'm personally using it as a submixer just to route all my keyboards through here. It's very practical, very handy. I've used it in a live setting. I've used it in a church service using this, and then also using the MIDI capabilities with MainStage. Altogether, you have the potential of having like a very expandable and powerful keyboard rig using hardware and software. I'm using the main outputs of this to go into the DAW, but it also has monitor outputs. Cables, I am using Mogami silver cables, great quality. I know people are a bit skeptical when you tell that there's a difference in quality when it comes to sound of cables. You know, you have a lot of people that just say cables are cables, you know, it doesn't matter the brand. But I've noticed a sonic difference when I do use my Mogami cables, especially with the Nord. It does have like it gives me a brighter, punchier sound. Whereas with other cables, it may not have that same effect. It's a little bit more dull and just there. But that's a difference that I noticed for myself. And of course, you know, if you have any comment or feedback about that or have an opinion, feel free to comment on that in the comments. I'd love to have a discussion. I don't, you know, feel offended either way. But it works for me. Mogami cables all day. And from the Key Largo, the output of the Key Largo is going to this fella here, which is the Apollo Twin X by Universal Audio. Solid interface, great quality, great preamps. you're always going to get some good consistent sound from it. It works great for me. I love using it. I think I got it a couple of months ago. A friend of mine sold me his and the plugins that came with it, so that was pretty cool. Speaking of which, when I am tracking and I'm using the console companion app, where you can set even more parameters and presets, if you're using a Unison pre, which I do from time to time, I'll use the V76 preamp with this. And there's a preset in this plugin called the V76 tube warmth, and it gives a great amount of like color, warmth, punch to anything that I'm recording from audio from the Nord or even the Roland. Just makes it warm, it cuts through the mix, it sits in the mix very well. And of course, you know, if you know anything about Universal Audio, your Unison pre's are active when the LEDs are orange. But even without it, even if I don't use it and I take it out of the channel strip here in the console, I still get great sound. And of course, you have multiple channel strips that you can use, presets. I think I may have used this little pop chart piano preset going on here with this plugin here, which is the UA16B. And let me get out of here. What else is in the channel strip? The UAD2. This is a Pultec EQ. And then also a, what is this down here? It's not going to show. Oh, there it is. And then also with this this plugin here, which is the P Reflections. And just, you know, being able to use any of these presets and parameters that come already made and thought of, I think it's really great for me. And sometimes I'll experiment and, you know, use whatever I feel like is necessary from time to time. But at any rate, this helps me. I love using it. And then I think now is a good time. Oh, before I even do that, headphones. Where'd it go? I'm using Biodynamic DT770s. These are very comfortable headphones. I can use these for hours at a time, and I don't feel any discomfort with them. They sound great. I use them on a regular, especially since I'm in an apartment space. So of course, you know, volume you have to be conscious of. Respect your neighbors, don't get put out. And yeah, these headphones are great for me. They work, I love them. Let's talk about speakers. So this pair of monitors are JBL Series 3 studio monitors. Nothing crazy, nothing drastic, mainly because, number one, I don't need any real high-end speakers in my space that I'm in. I don't do a lot of mixing per se, so that's why, number one, I don't have any more like high-end monitors, and that's why they're not at that equilateral configuration that, you know, most engineers and producers or whatever, you know, the case is, they may have it set up that way for that equilateral triangle effect for stereo imaging while you're mixing. But I don't do a lot of mixing, you know, in my line of work, but they're there, they're general, they sound great. And they're sitting on some RLX isolation pads sitting there to provide that, you know, separation. What am I missing? Okay, so the computer. So this computer is actually a 2017 15-inch MacBook Pro, 500 gigabyte hard drive, 16 gigs of RAM, quad-core Intel processor, Retina display. Good machine. I've never had an issue with it. I have external drives that I use. They're G drives. I have one G drive that is a terabyte, and that is a mobile USB-C hard drive, and I use that for my samples. I have a 4 terabyte hard drive behind the computer, and that's where I keep my sessions and just hold on to those and make sure that they're there and just, you know, used accordingly so that I don't jam my resources on the computer. And for the record, they're tucked away back here. So those are the G drives. Got a couple of USB hubs, good old iLock. It's a blessing and a curse with that, but that's where I have everything set up. So yeah, this is just my home configuration. Let me know what you think in the comments. The desk. Both the desk and this stand that my other keyboards are on, those are both by OnStage Stands. I think the one thing that I want to do in the near future is to upgrade to a different desk workstation, or workstation desk rather, and buy one that has like the drawer to put the controller in, so I can just tuck it away when it's not in use. Because not all the time do I feel comfortable just reaching over the controller to use the computer. So I'm starting to appreciate anything and all things ergonomically sound. And but they're good stands if you're just starting out and just need a starting point. They're good for that. But any of these items that I've described or displayed, rather, I will put a link to them in the description on my Amazon account if you decide to check them out or make a purchase. And of course, that would help me support my channel and even make those upgrades. And potentially I can come back and talk about, you know, if I upgrade to a better work desk. But for now, this is it. Thank you for tuning in. I appreciate it. Give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, give a comment, let me know what you think. Whether it's good, bad, hideous, whatever, it's all good. Anything is good conversation. But thank you for checking it out. I'm going to sign out from here. Much love to everybody, and peace out.